Welcome to Lincoln Park Zoo. Today on Stay Tuned to the Zoo, we're gonna learn about a very interesting animal. But before I reveal it to you, I'm gonna have you try to figure it out through a mystery drawing where I describe to you what the animal is using simple shapes, and you're gonna try to guess it at the end. So go ahead and grab a piece of paper and a pen right now. Now that you have your paper in front of you, draw an oval right in the center of that paper. Next, draw a long, skinny rectangle connecting the right side of the oval and then going up towards the top of the paper. Now at the top of that rectangle, draw a circle just a little bit to the right but overlapping that original rectangle. Now even further to the right on that circle, draw sort of a pickle or kidney bean shape just barely overlapping the edge of that circle, kind of long. Once you've done that, in the upper right corner or edge of that circle, you can draw sort of a large dot. Now go back down to that original oval that we first drew, and from the middle, draw a straight line all the way down almost to the bottom of the paper. Now go back to that top of that line where it's touching the oval, and draw another line that goes over to the right on an angle, and then back across, almost like it's gonna create a triangle, and then overlap that original line. What do you think this animal is that we're gonna learn about today? Hopefully you guessed flamingo, because that's what we're gonna talk about today on Stay Tuned to the Zoo.
Today on Stay Tuned to the Zoo, we are stomping in to meet the colony of flamingos that call our zoo home. When many people visit the zoo in the winter and the temperatures drop, they're always amazed to see the flamingo colony out and thriving. But it's important to note that here at Lincoln Park Zoo, we thoughtfully select the species that call our zoo home. And we are home to a colony of Chilean flamingos. These species are native to South America and can live at elevations as high as 14,000 feet. That's about 3 miles high, to put it in perspective. These birds can thrive in extreme temperatures, which makes them really tolerant of Chicago and our midi seasons. Here at Lincoln Park Zoo, we want to carefully plan and make decisions to make sure that they have the best space here at the zoo as well. And as you look behind me, you'll notice their habitat is broken up into a couple of different sections. They have a wetland space, a watery space that's about shin high, where they can spend time bathing, preening or cleaning their feathers, or even practicing their famous filter feeding behavior. They also have a nice flat muddy part in their habitat. This is a space where they can feed. Our keepers have designed special knee-high feeders for the colony of flamingos here at the zoo. These knee-high feeders offer the flamingos a chance to feed and also prevent other birds that might be visiting the pond from sneaking any of their vet-approved daily diet. When flamingos are feeding, something you can't see is when they're tilting their head upside down and shaking it back and forth, they are filtering out water in and out of their beak or bill really quickly. They use their tongue almost like a piston to do this, and when that water is coming out, the lamellae or comb-like structures along their bill are catching that algae and crustaceans that are part of their diet. So those feeders offer a great opportunity to encourage and promote that natural filter feeding behavior. Another really important part of the flamingo's home that isn't super active right now is their nesting area. During breeding season, our keepers will provide a sprinkler system to keep the mud nice and soft. That's because flamingos make their nest out of mud. They'll roll it near their feet and create that perfect nesting structure. So keepers have those sprinklers to create that perfect substrate for them. Providing that space is a great opportunity to make sure that the flamingo colony here at Lincoln Park Zoo is thriving. Flamingos are a favorite species for many because of their beautiful coloration, their social nature, and all of the vocalizations that they make. They get that beautiful pink hue from their diet. They are going to be looking for algae and crustaceans, and these things have something called carotenoids in them. It's a pigment, and that pigment is giving them the beautiful pink coloration in their feathers. This takes about 3 years to develop and for all of their feathers to turn pink. When flamingos are born, they're about this tall and a white-gray fluffy color. You'll also notice as the colony is hanging out in their space together that flamingos are a very social species. They stand shoulder to shoulder, and this might seem uncomfortable for you and I, but crowded conditions are really beneficial for flamingos, and in fact, they thrive in those conditions. Flamingos practice something called safety in numbers. They'll stay together as a close-knit colony, and they'll move as one. As they're moving and spending time in their habitat, they'll make sure to communicate with each other through vocalizations, but also through behaviors and body language. These behaviors are most notable during breeding season, where you'll see the colony moving all together and doing the same behavior almost at the same time. It's an incredible display to see. One of my favorite behaviors to see is called a head flagging behavior. This is when the flamingos stand as tall as they can, they stretch their neck and head up tall, and they flick their head from side to side really quickly. But not just one flamingo does this, the whole colony will do this at once. And at the same time, they're vocalizing loudly together. Another really common behavior we might get the chance to see during breeding season is called a wing salute. That's when the flamingos will hold their wings out as far as they can, which is about 3.5 to 5 feet long, and they'll stretch their neck and their legs and their tail feathers as far as they can, and they'll vocalize together again as a colony. These behaviors, these vocalizations, and the close-knit nature of the colony here at Lincoln Park Zoo is a way that they stay safe and comfortable living together. Lincoln Park Zoo has been lucky to also have chicks born right here at Lincoln Park Zoo. The nesting space offers that great opportunity for the flamingos to practice that nest building behavior, and keepers can monitor the nest and monitor the eggs when they hatch to make sure that everything is going according to plan. As you look into the colony behind me, you might see some of the flamingos still have a couple gray feathers here or there, and that's indicating that they are juveniles from the most recent hatches here at Lincoln Park Zoo. Thanks so much for joining us for our chat today. I hope you got the opportunity to learn more about this unique species that call Lincoln Park Zoo home.
Now that we learned about some flamingos, let's learn some dance moves based on their behaviors. I have two helpers with me, Nicole and Jordan. Watch Jordan for some of the modified versions of these dance moves. The first move that we're gonna learn is the twist and preen. Often you see birds cleaning their feathers and we call that preening. So stand on one leg and just kind of move your arm and your head together. And it's okay if you fall over a little. Sometimes it's hard to stand on one leg. The next move we're gonna learn is the stretch. A lot of times we see birds doing this when they wake up. They stretch their wing and their leg at the same time, kind of opposite each other. Stretch. Stretch. The other thing we often see flamingos doing is feeding by stomping their feet to kick up stuff on the ground inside the water and then moving their head back and forth. So now we'll learn the stomp and feed. Stomp your feet, move your head back and forth, and you can even spin in a circle a little bit. Don't make yourself too dizzy though. The last move we're gonna learn is called the display, and we see flamingos doing this during mating. They stick their head way out and flap their wings. Sometimes they kind of move their legs a little too. All right, now let's put those all together. The twist and preen, the stretch, the stomp and feed, and the display. Twist and preen, stretch. Stomp and feed. Display. As they keep going, I'm gonna tell you, thanks for joining us at Stay Tuned to the Zoo. Maybe you can teach some of these moves to your own flock at home. Subscribe for new videos every Tuesday and Thursday.